What backup program should I use? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Backing up is kind of like eating healthier. Everybody knows we should, but few of us actually do it. Much like the heart attack victim who no longer binges on French fries, when it comes to backing up, the most dedicated are those who've been bitten hard by a failure in their past. Asking what backup program to use is very much like asking, what's the best exercise program? The best program for exercise, or backing up, is the one you'll actually do. Now, I'm going to look at 7 questions to ask yourself and my recommendations along the way. First, do I want to put a lot of thought into this? If this isn't something you want to spend time learning about, and to be honest, most people don't, then prepare to spend a little bit more money for some additional disk space and get a good, dedicated backup program. In other words, just do this. Get an external hard drive. Get backup software such as EaseUS Todo or Macarium Reflect. Configure the backup software to take monthly full backups and daily incremental backups and manage the space on the external drive. Yes, there's some work involved in getting things set up, but once it's in place, you're mostly done. 2, am I comfortable reinstalling my system? This is a comfort versus space trade-off. If you're okay with reinstalling your system from scratch, meaning your operating system and all of the applications and all of the customizations, and you can clearly identify what does and does not need to be saved, you can save a lot of disk space by backing up only your data. This requires a great deal of diligence on your part because anything you don't specify to be backed up will be lost in the case of a catastrophic failure. Either way, you need to use a technique, either homebrewed or in the form of a backup or automated copy program, to make sure all of this happens automatically. Relying on your memory to back up, not the best choice. 3, is there another computer on my network? You might not have to get other hardware for backup purposes. Hard disks are so large these days that simply having another machine on your local network with enough free space can be a quick and easy solution. Many backup programs allow you to back up across a network. Having 2 machines back each other up is a quick way to ensure that if either has a problem, your data is safe on the other. It does mean you'll have to set up your local network and enable file sharing on it, something that isn't always the easiest to accomplish. 4, how valuable is what you're doing? What if your computers and all of your backups disappeared in a fire? If that potential data loss just sent a shiver down your spine, you should consider off-site storage for at least some of your backups. That could mean periodically taking an external disk with your backups to some other location, or if the sizes are small enough, backing up across the network to a server not in your home. When my wife and I had a retail store, I had an external backup drive for backups at her store and another one here in our home. I would just periodically swap the two. Each location then had the off-site backup for the other. Another approach in recent years might be even easier. If the amount of data you're backing up is manageable and your internet connection is relatively fast, an online backup system may be worth considering. These programs back up your critical files to secure servers on the internet, giving you data and offsite backup at the same time. In addition, some services will allow you to access your backed up files from any machine connected to the internet. Now, this approach is impractical for large backups, such as full image or complete system backups due to upload speed and storage size limitations. But you might also consider services like Dropbox or OneDrive or Google Drive and many others. Data placed in folders managed by these services is automatically backed up to their servers and to any other computers you install the software on, should you choose. 6, how important is incremental access? How important is it that you be able to recover a file from a specific date, not a day before or a day after, a specific date. If you simply back up all your files on top of previous versions, you'll only have the most recent version. Many times, that's enough. Sometimes it's not. If, for example, you need to recover an older version of a file that became corrupt at some point. Number 7, what resources should I back up? Have you thought about all your computers? All the drives therein? How about external hard drives you're not using for backup? Do you have a website? Do you have a backup of it? What would happen if your ISP lost it? It's happened. If you're a small business, do you have databases that need backing up? Are your books online and only online? Do office computers belong to everyone but no one? What about email? What about your operating system? There's a lot to think about. Now I get it. These questions can seem overwhelming. I really want you to take action and ensure that your precious data is backed up somehow, somewhere. I hear often, too often, from people who have lost too much. It's downright heartbreaking at times. The approach I outlined at the start is the basis for one approach that should work very well for many, if not most, home and small business users. Equip each computer with an external drive. It should be at least 4 times as large as the amount of space currently used on the computer's existing drives. Install an image backup program such as EaseUS Todo or Macrim Reflect. Configure that program to take monthly full image backups and then daily incremental images. Discard backups older than, say, 2 months, which can often be done automatically by the software. Install a data sharing program such as Dropbox or OneDrive or similar, and store your data in files and folders managed by those programs for automatic offsite and cloud backup of the files you work on every day. I'll call this an 80% solution. It's something that'll work really well for most people. It won't be exactly right for some, but it is absolutely a start. The bottom line for backing up is simple. Just do it. Understand what you have and what you're willing to invest in, but do something before it's too late. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/1894. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.